Joining us now is Dr. Samadi, Dr. David Samadi, chair of the urology and chief of robotic surgery at Lenox Hill Hospital, also professor of urology at Hofstra North Shore LIJ School of Medicine. Hello, doc.
Hey, Steve. How are you?
Good. How are you? Good to see you again.
We had a nice week. All is well. Thank you.
Good. Good. Well, you know, I'm listening to Obama talk about Obamacare right now. We've been carrying parts of his press conference live as he holds a pre-vacation press conference. And then I have this story in my hand here, and you and I have talked about this, how they're bracing for Obamacare, and nurse practitioners are now being used and will be used more and more to fill the doctor shortage. Why is there going to be a doctor shortage?
Well, you know, this is something that we've talked in the past, and if you're going to add about 30 million patients on this system, there's no way that given the current number of doctors that we have, we're going to be able to carry this kind of volume. Already as it is, doctors are spending less time with their patients, they're seeing more volume, and when the quantity goes up, the quality will go down if you're going to spend less time. I can tell you that if you use the nurse practitioners or physician assistants or medical assistant the right way, you may be able to get away and be able to do almost 80% of the stuff that we do as a physician. It's always that 15-20% that requires certain training that we get as doctors that they may not get, and to put them in those kind of situations, it's not fair, and they can make mistakes. Now, when it comes to writing prescriptions and a lot of those things, and in my field of urology, putting catheters, etc., yes, they can do that. But when it comes to decision making, the thought process, differential diagnosis, those kind of things, you know, they're not trained to do that. So I think it's going to be a challenging task ahead of us.
All right, I couldn't agree with you more. All right, let's talk about George W. Bush. On Monday, we all found out that he went in for a physical, and then on Tuesday, I believe he had a had the stent put in to open a clogged artery, which they said was about 80 or 90, maybe, I don't know, 90% clogged. In all likelihood, he had a stress test, or either that, or he had to have one of those angiograms. Otherwise, you can't find out that an artery is clogged, correct?
Exactly right. So probably what happened is, and you know that with Fox News, every year he does the 100K, and we cover that extensively. He's obviously very active. He likes to bike, and he exercises all the time. So it's a little bit of a surprise to see this kind of blockage, and that the message is that, yes, you can exercise, but you want to make sure that your cholesterol, your blood pressure, all of that is in order. What happened with him is probably he had some mild chest pain or some sort of a symptom, maybe short of breath, and he went and saw his doctors. They decided to get the angiogram, as you mentioned, and they basically go through the groin and they get to the arteries, they inject some dye, and they see some sort of a blockage. I remember actually about a decade ago when I was at Columbia Presbyterian, Clinton, President Clinton, he came in, and it was the same exact phenomenon where he also got the cardiac stent. I think we are fortunate to be able to put these stents across the vessels that have 80-90% blockage. These patients used to go for what we call a bypass surgery. It was a major operation that required opening their chest, major surgery to get them to bypass that lesion. And now with this stent, which is a metal tube that kind of opens up that obstruction, we're able to save them and make sure that the heart is not damaged, the muscles are not damaged. So he's going to be under close surveillance. They're going to test him with a whole bunch of tests for his cardiac function and stress tests, make sure he'll be fine, and he'll move on. And the chances are that maybe in the future he'll need another one, but certainly this was a big save over here.
Doctor, we got a minute left, so just tell the folks, even if they're perfect weight and perfect physical activity and very active and eats right and think that they're, you know, they're mountain biking and jogging, and when should they look for help?
Well, I think that you have to look at individuals and you have to look at their medical issues. Somebody who is diabetic, somebody who has like high blood pressure, they have high cholesterol, even if they exercise and they eat healthy, they may have some underlying physiologic issues in their vessels that may get this kind of lesions. So yes, go ahead and exercise and make sure you eat healthy food, but you need to be under close surveillance.
Right.
making sure that the vessels are fine and there's no obstruction.
Doc, we'll see you next week. Dr. David Samadi, Chairman of Urology and Chief of Robotic Surgery at Lenox Hill Hospital and Professor of Urology at Hofstra North Shore LIJ. You watch him on Fox News. Always good to talk to you, sir. We're coming back. Dr. Ben Carson joins us on the Steve Malzberg Show.